Hello.
Hey, Isaac! Hey, Isaac!
What's up?
What's up?
Hey. Oh my god, I like you guys for sure that it gets. Okay, it's good to be back, people. Okay, so hello here. I'm your agenda manager, Eugene. And here we have Julie here as the summit manager, also kind of the agenda manager. Yeah, but she will be on the background because she's mainly coordinating on the registration form, all the things that, not beforehand, behind the scenes, but she's still with us, okay? Yeah, so let's go to the next one. Yeah, so what will I do here as the agenda manager? It's mainly to let you know what you are going into, like what is EB Summit about, okay? Yeah, so mainly the objective here, I think you guys also saw in the registration form already, right? The first thing is to shape the right values and mindset among our next generation of leaders, which is everyone here, to let you know what is the value and mindset that I should have as an EB, okay? Moving on, the second one is also for you to understand the essential roles to play as an entity leader and as a team player, because you guys don't have the EB experience, right? So you come here to understand what is your essential role, okay? And the last part is also to understand and appreciate continuity and understand how it contributes towards sustainability. Mainly for your LC, you know, it's not only you alone, but then your whole LC bringing on the legacy towards the next term, okay? Yeah, so moving on. Yeah, so mainly our agenda here, right? So, you know, as everyone requested, we have 2 days here, and maybe these 2 days have two key highlights, two key messages, okay? Which the day one starts with leading with the right values, okay? And day two is leading sustainably with continuity. So now I'll go to even more detail in terms of what we'll go through. Yeah, so maybe here we have the opening plenary by EJ here, you know, starting that she entertained you guys with a very, very interesting video. Yeah, and then at the same time, moving on, after this session, now, right now, opening plenary, right? Then we'll have value-driven leaders who positively impact the world around them. So mainly here, we'll let you know about, you know, like why is it important to have uphold a very strong value towards your LC as an entity leader like this? And how does this value actually influence and impact the people around you, the community, and most importantly, the world like that? But of course, I wouldn't read too much because later you'll be experiencing it. Then we'll go towards a lunch break, you know, for you guys to rest and eat, recharge. And then we'll go into one of the things that you guys are most excited on is towards the split track, okay? So for LCP and LCEB, you will know your unique contribution as your respective role here, okay? So we have our respective FACs, you know, ready to be in their breakout rooms, ready in a different link later, yeah, after lunch. And afterwards, you'll continue, you will take a break first, and then you'll continue to also understand how to understand and build your team. Yeah, so mainly here for LCP and LCEB, we have different track, different sessions delivering to you guys, okay? And then lastly, we'll close today with the evening plenary. So remember to, you know, go through the whole agenda and session today to understand how to lead with the right values. Yeah, then moving on day two, which is tomorrow, but I wouldn't explain too detail right now. It's mainly morning plenary as usual. Then we also understand the beauty of this organization, but you know, what is this session about tomorrow, we will know, okay? Then we're also going to the functional fair that you guys, you know, are also very excited about because you guys have the respective functions that you want to aim for, achieve for, and then we'll also go towards lead with purpose, bloom with impact, okay? So in case you don't know, this is our term stand, MC Blossom stand. But in terms of what is inside, then, you know, by that time, you'll know, okay? Stay tuned. And then lastly, we'll go towards the closing plenary. And by this day, we'll, you know, let you know more how to lead sustainably with continuity, okay? Mainly that's all for the 2 days agenda. Yeah, so I think just before I pass back towards our, you know, respective FACI towards our opening plenary, I just want to set an expectation to you guys. Yeah, so again, we are coming here, you know, I know some of you guys may want to apply, may don't want to apply, and then you're still thinking, but again, no matter what's your decision, I think the first thing is always embrace uncertainties as opportunities. So I think here everyone also know that we will have a lot of change management coming and, you know, external environment is also very uncertain, but we need to stay resilient and see it as an opportunity. Again, your ROI values. Then moving to the next one, ownership, own your learning and also own your energy. Yeah, so mainly set your learning goal. Ensure that it's 100% achieved. What do you want to come in here? You are spending 2 days with us. If you don't get the most out of it, it's not worth for you. And at the same time, own your energy also. You know, take your rest, sleep well, sleep early, drink your water, yeah, eat your food. You know, ensure that you are healthy, you have the energy. And lastly, in terms of the innovative mindset, it's more towards staying humble to seek improvement while preserving your core. So what do I mean by this? You know, innovative in EB Summit is mainly ask about GCPs and then also personalize it. So it's not only on the operational aspect, but it's also in terms of the leadership where you are going to meet a lot of different leaders here. Some of you guys have the experience, some of you guys don't have. Yeah, but you can have more conversation with each other, understand how you manage teams, inspire them, you know, and then see whether it fits for you or not. Okay, so that's all for the expectation from my side. I'll pass it back to Yijie to continue the opening plenary.
Thank you, Jin.
Thank you, Jin.
Okay, so yeah, thanks. Our agenda manager, which is Eugene, and also the our co-agenda manager, which is Julie, for creating such a beautiful agenda for our EV summit. Okay, so let's go to the next. So yeah, let's come back to this opening plenary. Since you have already got to know about like what is going to cover in this EV summit, right? So let's let's take out your pen and notebook. Before we start our day, let's do some like journaling to set up like what is the goals that we want to achieve in this EV summit, okay? So I will give you 10 seconds for you to take out your pen and notebook. If you are done, then you can put a wave in the chat box, okay? So that I get to know. Yeah. If you have, you can take your time to grab a pen and notebook. So let's start with setting our personal goals. Like, what do you want to achieve? Okay, let's set 3 learning goals. Like a very simple one. It can be simple as like I want to have conversation with the FASI, to get to know their leadership experience so that I can learn from them. Or it can be anything like you want to learn in this EB summit. Like for example. Example, get to know about what is the change management, or get to know about how into my team, this kind of thing. Yeah, so I will give you some time to actually write down. Okay. Okay, meanwhile, open some music. If you're done, you can put a wave in the chat box as well so that I can get to know that you have already done. Okay, we have Sami done. With the 3 learning goals that you have, right? So what action you need to take to achieve the goals that you set? Okay, yeah, you can write down the actions that you want to do in order for you to achieve your goals. Okay, yeah, take some time to think. Thank you. Yes, if you're done, you can put a wave in the chat box as well. Okay, I can see a lot of people have already done. Okay, so yeah, you can, if you still haven't done, you can take the time to write down, like wrap up like the last of a few actions that you want to take. But then definitely whatever you have written down in your notebook, don't forget that this will be the goals that you want to achieve in these two days, as what we have set the expectation at the beginning on your learning in this EB Summit, like whether you have learned or you have never learned before, just unlearn and relearn. So, and then you will get out of, so that you can get out of, most out of this summit, okay? All right, so with that, right, so in this day one that we will talk about, we will have like a lot of sessions that covered about living with the right value. So before we go into our next session, talking about more deep down into like, more detail into the like, the values, and also how can you with the different kind of sessions that cover value-driven leadership. So let's look into values, okay? So I want you to also look into these values and to write down in your notebook as well. Why do you think it's important to actually understand about our own values, okay? So you can take some time to think and to reflect, why do you think it is important for you to actually understand about your own values, okay? Yeah, so let's have some time to write down as well. Okay, once you have write down, right, talking about understand about our own values, then why do we need to live our life with values as well? Yeah, you can write down in your notebook. If you're done, you can put in the chat box, a wave in the chat box. Yeah, I still need more response, okay? We have 70 participants here. So yeah, I'm expecting 70 responses. Okay, all right. So thanks everyone for writing down. So I hope you get to reflect a little bit on why do you personally think is it important to understand your own values, and then why do we need to live our life with values. But definitely what you have written down is not only share with your notebook, right? Okay, the most important thing is also share your own opinions. Share about what do you think, and then we will have like a breakout room sharing. So later we will send you to share about your own talks, like 3 to 4 person per room, and then you will have 5 minutes to share about your personal and you feel with values. But don't restrict yourself in sharing. Just open up if you feel shy, because you never know whether your words will actually inspire others, right? Okay, so we'll have like our techie to send you guys to the breakout room, and then you guys can share. Okay. Yeah, so yeah, you can go to the breakout room right now. Every one of you, like, what have you shared in the breakout room, or like share about your own opinion? It can be something that you learn from others, or it can be something that you want to share to the plenary. Yeah, you can grab your chance. Anyone?
Hi, can I share?
Hi. Yes, sure.
Okay, so why importance towards the value? I think there's a collection on it's actually not just about the principle that how we live, but then it's actually also show the bottom away on the bottom line, also how we can present who am I to other people and let people know where is our bottom line, and also it represents how we play the role of me, myself, yeah. So that's all.
Okay, nice. So it's about more on like how it represents you, also how you live it, how you have your daily behaviors and daily action in your life. It's actually based on like the values that you have, right? Okay, thanks, Nathan. Yeah, snap, snap. So can we have one more people to share? Yeah, let's have one more. Anyone?
I think I can go.
Yeah, yes, sure.
Well, for me, I'll answer for the second question, like why do we need to live our life with values?
Yes, sure.
Yeah, so for me, like my why is like value is like something, you know, it will direct us, like give us some direction, like in whichever things that we do. So it's like we will think deeper and try to relate it with the values that we want to achieve. So we will act in a how to say, it will guide us on the right direction. Yeah, I think that's all for me.
Yes, thanks, Ching Hong. Thank you for your sharing. Yeah, it's not like how they guide you, the direction that you want and how it guides you, like a bottom line for you to make a decision in your life. Okay, thanks, Ching Hong, for your sharing. Yeah, this is also exactly what I'm going to share later on. So when we talk about values, right, I think whether or not you actually really understand about your personal value, like what is the things that you think is something that it is cannot missing in you. So if let's say you're unable to find, right, so actually values is about what makes you happy, okay? So like what makes me happy is something that, like for example, it can be when I have a conversation with my friend and then every time I be with my friend and that's what makes me happy, then maybe you value about your personal value is about relationship or even friendship, for example, or what makes you fulfill, or and it can be also what makes you satisfied, and also last but not least, also what makes you proud. Okay, so if you're unable to find out like what are the values, or maybe you're not sure whether is it you really is your personal value, or maybe it's just a lot of on like you're not sure who are you, whether do you know like whether do you really understand about yourself, try to think about and reflect about what makes me happy, what makes me fulfilled, what makes me satisfied, and also what makes me proud. And all these important moments is a time that you will know like these are the values itself that keep in you is something that makes you happy and also makes you feel fulfilled and satisfied every day in your life. Okay, so if that right, I just give an example. But then I actually have to work 30 hours per week where I do not have a lot of time to spend with my family. And then let's think about, will you actually have any like conflict or stress, internal conflict or stress or not? Because you value about your family. I mean, your personal value is about family. I care about my family. I care about like people around me. But then let's say if one day you have to choose, like you make a decision that you will actually, let's say value competition, but you're actually in an environment that is very competitive around you, will you feel happy or will you feel satisfied? Will you feel proud even though when you actually achieve or how? Because that is not your personal value, right? So with that, right, I think today, this entire day one of the Leaf Summit, not Leaf Summit, it's the EV Summit that we will talk about leading with the right values. So I hope that let's go to the next part. So with that, right, in this opening plenary, what do you think are the things that still missing in this summit? Yeah, you can type in the chat box, or you still require, let's say if you require something now, okay, you can let us know. Okay, what are still missing? No
fun,
one?
Fun, fun.
No one? Okay, we have people say fun, fun, fun. Okay, we also have people put chair, okay? Yeah. So only a few people fun, is it? Okay, we have people put table. Thanks, Joey. Okay, it's a nice joke. Okay, let's welcome our table, okay? No, just kidding. So let's welcome the most important peeps in the area of the conference and also the most fun element in the conference, which is Fun Team! Yay! Okay, okay. Okay. Sorry, Okay, can you guess who is the fun team? You can have a guess who are the fun team, okay? Yeah, you can type in the chat box. The bass and the tweeters make the speakers go to war. Yeah, you can type in the chat box who are the fun team. Darlene, they say it's Darlene. It's Eugene, it's Darlene. They want Coco. Okay, you can put it, they want. Who type brownies? Don't make Let's welcome our... Tell me where the freak's at. Okay,
let me.
I'm okay. Yeah, you can talk.
Yeah. Hello, can you hear me?
Can hear you.
Okay, great, great. Yeah, so we are JJ, and then you can see especially me and Jonah. So I'm JJ, I'm Jonah, and then you can see we also have our own logo. So the logo is actually from Johnson & Johnson. Okay. Yeah, next. Okay, so yeah, I think just some short introduction about me. So I'm Jen Xuan. I'm the current MCVP MPD, MCVP MPD at GTA. So I'm actually, so in Isaac, we actually have one Isaac code, which is called U1. I mean, which is called Isaac relationship code. But for me, I'm U1. Then we have next, I'll pass my partner, Jonah.
Okay, yes. Hi, everyone. Yeah, I'm Jonah, MCVP, current MCVP OGTA. And yeah, my Isaac code is A3. So if you're wondering what is the difference between all these codes, if you don't know, we'll tell you later on. But yeah, you can see the difference between me and Zhenxuan is quite vast. So want to know more, hit us up later. Yep, so back to you, Zhenxuan.
Okay, great. Thanks, Jonah. So next. Okay, so in conference, why we have fun team? So I think it's very simple. It's just only two things. First, you want to hype your up. So we can see this baby. I think it's a she. Okay, yeah, she's very happy. Okay, next one. We also want to give you fun, right? Okay, so you can see this SpongeBob. So you have a lot of fun with us later. Okay, stay tuned. And next part. So some expectation setting for you is just very simple. I only have two. One is enjoy the process because we know that it's going to be a very stressed conference. It may be for someone, but I hope that you all can enjoy throughout the whole process. And second thing, it is what it is. So if let's say you cannot find him, that means it is what it is, because I think that's the destiny for you. Okay, so just two expectations, I think. Enjoy the process and it is what it is. Okay, next. Okay, so I think a lot of time when we come to a summit and conference, so it's very important because we actually want to spread love. Because in Isaac, we also spread peace as well. So coming to us, Sami and conference, we hope that there will be more peace and love being spread out. And in the end, we can maybe create a next generation of Isaac baby as well. So with that, we actually want to introduce Isaac code for you all. So that's a very, I think this is a very simple Isaac code, which I think most of you maybe will see before. Next, yeah. So we have a few. We have A means available, O occupied, C is complicated, U is unavailable. Okay, so I think what's the difference or what is the example of it? We'll give you one example. So first, you put a number behind. One means that you have one relationship before. Okay, so for example, U1 means that you have one relationship and you are currently unavailable. Okay, so this is the example like me. Okay, another one is A0, which is in our MC team, there's Lermin, Jali, and Eugene. So you see these three, they're A0. Okay, I mean, I don't know what happened to them, but anyway, we hope that they can have one number at the back soon. Yeah. Okay. So I will give them maybe 1 minute for everyone. You can change your code. So A means available means that you are open for a relationship. O means occupied means that you are in a relationship right now. C means complicated. I don't know what happened to you, but maybe you are in the mood of having, you are in the mood of not having. And U is available means that you are not looking for a relationship at the current moment. Yeah. So I'll give me 1 minute. I will play some funny songs as well. You can just change. Yeah, you can just change. Okay, I saw some people changing. Maybe more people, you can just change in front. Yeah, you can just change. Come, no need to be shy. It's okay to be A0. I think that's also a proud achievement. Okay, we saw some A, saw some O. Okay, great people. Okay, so with that, we also come up with a few background for you as well. So if you want to be much more obvious, you wanted to really be in a relationship. So there are three things. So first is single background. So you can just change it towards the background. In green color means that you are actually ready to mingle. Okay, so this is like people to notice about you. So you can see in this conference, you don't have any virtual background, right? So we actually prepared this for you. See, means complicated means that I don't know what happened to myself. I don't, I mean, yeah, so sometimes people, you might feel that you are in the, you are in green or you are in red. So I hope that maybe you can just choose one color. I hope don't, yeah, I hope you can, we don't see any yellow color lah. And red means that you are taken, means that you are in relationship. Then I will just say all the best to you. And I hope that you have a long relationship with your partner. Okay. So you, I think someone already sent the background to your in the chat box. You can, I mean, in the Telegram group as well. You can also go and change it. Okay. So without further ado, I'll pass to my partner Jonah to actually introduce the next game.
Okay. Yeah. So hi everyone. So in this, wait, next. Yeah. So as part of Fun Team, we actually have an initiative or some type of competition for everyone. Yeah, we call it the EB Summit Tournament. And the name is R&R with J&J. Yeah, I will admit it's not the most creative name, but it's the content that counts, okay? Yeah, so moving on, in what is in this tournament? So the tournament details is as follows. This tournament is around, it will last throughout the whole of the 2 days of EB Summit, means today and tomorrow. And then it will also be about, yeah, delegates will be awarded points for each successful challenge that you accomplish. So stay tuned. And yeah, the whole premise of the tournament is collect as many points as possible and stay alert on the challenges that you will see later on. So yeah, definitely there is prizes for, yeah, there are prizes for the top three delegates of first, second, and third. But what are these prizes? I think there's now a bit of teaser there, but I'll say it again. So first place, you have 2 Tea Life of your choice, sponsored by Isaac Malaysia. Yes, I forgot our sponsor name. I'm so sorry. But yeah, 2 Tea Life of your choice. Anything, okay? But and also plus 1 and yeah, 1 mystery gift. And for third place, just the mystery gift. I'm so sorry. But yeah, I think for first place, right, there's 2 Tea Life. You can if you voucher or Isaac t-shirt, free one, or postcard with MC Blossom signature. So we will have all 9 MCs sign this postcard for you. And then 3 years down the road, you'll see, think like, oh, all these people are going many places. Maybe some become AIP or some go, PAI, sorry. Some become PAI, then some go to RO. Then you never know, someone become prime minister, huh? Okay. Tomorrow. So how to get points? There are actually 3. So we have our challenges based around our ROI. So resilient challenge wise is if you fill in the feedback form properly, you will get points. Okay, this is something that I think, yeah, it's kind of basic, but you all know what to do for this. The ownership challenge here is like sharing in Telegram or in plenary. So just now I think we had 2 people sharing already. You guys already have a head start. What's your names again? Tell us. So in plenary, that's right. Okay. Moving on, we also have 1 special challenge. So what is it? It's called Sticker Hunt. So throughout the whole of day one, you can find the blossom stickers scattered throughout the slides. So what are blossom stickers? You can see there, we have 3 variations, but it will be in multiple locations. So if you are attending all sessions, then you will know how many there are. Yeah, so just now in our introduction slide, there were 4, if you remember. Oh. I shouldn't say it, but yeah, there are 4, okay? Okay, yeah. So also, points are awarded if you can accurately report how many stickers appeared in the whole day one. So yeah, this is 4 challenges for this part. And yeah, last but not least, we have 1 more surprise, 1 more service. So it's called the EBBB Confession Form. And yeah, EB is, I think you all know what EB is, you are here for this summit, but BB definitely is like a BB, yeah, that type. So what is this form? Come on, let's show. Yeah, so this form, right, is like for you to put down your appreciation or confession to anyone you want to shout out to. So it can be anonymous, or you can put your name there if you want to confess to a guy or a girl that you find interested in, you have interest in, okay? Yeah, and also do share us some materials, because after you fill in this form, we will, After you fill in this form, it will be on our confession slide. So we have some samples here. Like you see, somebody write, why is Eugene so hot? I have no idea who thinks this, why you think my roommate is hot, but I do appreciate you. Okay, then also there's like, is Liang Jun single? Can I date him? Garlic looks like an onion after he cut his hair. So lang zai. Right, Garlic? And then also one more. I think Lermin is cuter than Travis. Whoever you are, Lermin thanks you. Right, Lermin? Yes, that's right. Okay, moving on. So that's all. All the best in this summit. And then, wait. That's all from J&J. So bye.
Thanks, thanks the fun team. So yeah, I hope that you get to participate on all of the fun element in this EB, the fun team session. And then definitely don't forget, like today you will have a leading with the right values, and then we talk about values, and then later on, I hope that you can able to find throughout your throughout the day one of EB Summit. Okay, so enjoy your EB Summit, yay! So let's welcome back. I will pass back to our agenda manager. Okay.
Okay, hello everyone, your agenda manager Eugene is back. So I hope you guys are not all, I hope you guys are excited, but not too excited because we are going to the next session, but we will give you guys a 2 minutes rest, so you can come back at 11:03 and we will prepare for the next session. And meanwhile, we also play some music. Yeah, but remember, come back, okay? Come back at 11:03. So I'll play some music.
Are you ready to give it all?